How's my hair? We're live. Oh, ha! Welcome to the Marco Polo case study. You probably recognize me from the campaign. I'm super famous. And also your host. The new Polo was coming, and Volkswagen wanted to get as many eyes on it as possible. So, we hid it. And invited South Africans to come play the world's biggest game of Marco Polo across social media, with a new Polo up for grabs. Thousands joined the hunt. Not me. Too busy protecting the city. Whatever, man. Hate that guy. We released clues on a different social platform every day. Fans had to guess its location using the hashtag Marco. And we responded in real time using the hashtag Polo. As the car jumped from location to location, so too did the game. We began on Facebook, then jumped to Twitter.
Marco!
Polo! Followed by Instagram, and ending on YouTube, where fans had to find a number hidden inside our ad and WhatsApp their best Marco voice note. The top three then battled it out for real in the grand finale in Utenay. The winner of Marco Polo was Faceplant. Ow! Only jokes, it was Kurt from Cape Town. Well done, buddy. But how did it do?
The results speak for themselves, but I'm going to say them anyway because I'm already speaking.
People loved it! We reached 640,000 unique individuals through daily clues, increased site traffic to the Polo page by 91%, damn, and recorded 55% of all configurations on the VW site, and got the whole country talking about the new Polo before it even arrived. Yeah, we trended and made lots of friends, but none of that matters unless cars get sold, and that's just what happened. The new Polo was South Africa's number one selling passenger vehicle, outselling its closest competitor by more than 50%. Suck it, Toyota. Guess that proves the new Polo is the car everyone's been looking for.
Marco!
Polo!